Hey foodies, welcome to CookingShooking. In this video, we are going to make a recipe of veg manchurian in gravy. Basically, it sounds like you have just added some more water to a veg manchurian dry version, and then you have your gravy version or your wet manchurian, but it is slightly different, guys. Today, we are going to make it in the restaurant style. As you can see, it looks super delicious, isn't it? So let's begin the recipe. Let's begin the recipe, guys. You can see all the ingredients right now. These are listed down below, so you can check that before making the recipe. Now let's begin. We are going to take a bowl. In this mixing bowl, I am taking 2.5 cups of finely chopped vegetables. You can use a food processor, a mixer grinder, or even a chopper like this to chop the vegetables. In this, I have 1/2 cabbage, 1 carrot, 4 to 5 French beans, and 1 medium-sized onion. We are going to season this with some salt. Along with that, I'm also adding 4 to 5 cloves of garlic, which are finely chopped. You can also use some garlic and ginger paste in this recipe. I'm also adding some chopped ginger. We are going to keep it simple, just salt and pepper. So I am adding some pepper right now. After that, we are going to mix it really well. This is the basic masala for our manchurian balls. Just mix it really well. After that, we are going to add the binding and the crisping agent. Basically, we are going to take the corn flour and the maida, 3 to 4 tablespoons each. Don't add too much at a time, guys. Add little bit at a time and then mix it really well. If you add too much, then your manchurian balls will be very doughy and tough. So less is more. So give it a good mix right now. As you can see, this is dry right now. There is a good coating of flour in the vegetables. Now when I mix it harshly, then it will start to combine. As you can see, our vegetable mixture has combined together, yet it has started to flow down similar to kinetic sand. So this is looking good. Now what we are going to do is make the manchurian balls. So just take a little bit of the portion and then shape it into a ball. Any size is fine, whatever you prefer. We are going to add this to the medium hot oil. Don't add too very hot oil, otherwise the maida and the corn flour will remain raw from center, which is not appetizing at all. This is a very simple recipe, guys. When we eat veg manchurian outside, that is usually cabbage manchurian, as you have seen in my cabbage manchurian video. This is slightly healthier compared to that reason, because we are using fresh oil as well as we are using much more vegetables, which makes it tastier as well. So once you see the manchurian balls going golden in medium hot oil, we are going to take them out. Right now, this is sunny golden. I'm going to fry it for a minute more. These are done. I'm going to take them out into a tissue. So the manchurian balls are ready and they are looking super good and crispy from outside and fluffy from inside. I'm going to make the second batch right now. After making the second batch, we are going to make the gravy for the manchurian. So the manchurian balls are done and they are looking great. Now let's make the gravy for the manchurian. We are going to heat up a very large utensil like a wok or a degchi. Degchi is something we all have in our homes, so you can use that in this recipe. Just heat it to very high. Once it is super hot, we are going to add oil from the sides. In this recipe, I am taking 2 tablespoons of oil. When we eat outside, that has much more oil. The oil will get hot instantly and that's when we will add the garlic. Garlic is the main ingredient for the gravy manchurian. Here I am taking 4 tablespoons of chopped garlic. Along with that, I'm also adding green chilli. This is 3 to 4 green chilies, which are finely chopped. Just give it a good mix and then cook it for 10 seconds or so. Flame is very high. That's why we are doing this step. Now it's time to add the cubed capsicum. Along with the capsicum, I'm also adding 1 onion, which is shelled. Basically, just cut the onion into large and then remove the shells. Basically, peel the onion, guys. We are also going to cook the sauces in the oil, so I am taking 1 tablespoon of soya sauce, 1 tablespoon of Schezwan sauce, and 1 tablespoon of red chili sauce. Just add them all together and then cook it for about a minute or so. Keep the flame very high. So if you have tasted the sauces, all of these are very sour. We have to balance them by adding some sugar or some ketchup. So here I'm taking about 1 tablespoon of tomato ketchup, which will add a slight sweetness as well as tomatoiness. Yes, that's a word. I'm going to give it a good mix right now. After that, we are going to add about 3 cups of water. This is room temperature water. You can also use hot water in this step. Just give it a good mix right now and we are going to wait for it to come to a boil. While the gravy is coming to a boil, what we are going to do is make a slurry. So here I'm taking 2 tablespoons of corn flour. You can also use arrowroot powder instead of corn flour. In this, I'm going to add about 3 to 4 tablespoons of water and then give it a good mix. This will basically thicken our gravy. You can also make the recipe without adding the corn flour. What you have to do is reduce the amount of water and then you will have a similar result. But then when you add corn flour, your gravy is much more silkier. So right now, just before the water is coming to a boil, we are going to begin adding the corn flour slurry little at a time. Don't add too much. Just add little bit and then give it a good mix. At the end, what we need is a thick and silky gravy. As you can see right now, I am adding little bit at a time and then our gravy is done. It looks thick, silky and shiny as well. Shiny basically means the gravy and the corn flour is cooked. You can adjust the color if needed by adding some more tomato ketchup, Schezwan sauce or even soya sauce. Mine looks good by adding some soya sauce. What we are going to do next is season it. If you recall, we haven't even added salt till now, so salt as per taste. Along with that, I'm also going to add some black pepper powder. If you are making this recipe for kids, please do not add the black pepper powder. If you want it 100% like restaurants, then you have to add some Ajinomoto or MSG. It is totally optional to add otherwise. Give this a mix. You can also add some spring onion greens if you want to. And after that, what we are going to add is the Manchurian balls. If you see carefully, the Manchurian balls are not completely round. Once you add to this, you will see them getting plump and bigger. I've turned off the flame right now. I'm going to mix it really well. We're going to keep it for about a minute or so before serving. I'm also going to sprinkle a little bit of spring onion greens. So there you go guys, our Manchurian recipe is done. Basically gravy Manchurian is done. If you see carefully, the gravy is very thick and silky and the Manchurian balls are round, plump and super soft. Just before serving, we are going to sprinkle a little bit of spring onion greens. Now doesn't that look delicious? So when I am trying this. So there you go guys, that was my veg Manchurian recipe. As you can see, it is super soft, super delicious and the gravy is so nice that you can eat it like that as well. It is sure a great addition to a fried rice or a chow mein, but best eaten just like it is. So try it out, share with me how it goes for you. See you soon with one more delicious recipe. Until next time, make sure to click the subscribe button down below and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified about my next video. Bye for now. Take care. Happy cooking.